Good morning, children. In geography, previous I have told for you the first lesson about the universe. The solar system I have explained. It continues. What is there in the solar system? There are the full moon is there, new moon is there, and different types of the planets also are there. We have learned in the first lesson. Today, the second lesson I am going to explain for you. That is the globe, latitudes and the longitudes. What do you mean by the globe? It is the globe means the true model of the earth. So what do you mean by the globe? The model of the earth I will show for you. It is the globe. Which shape it is there? It is there in the spherical shape, or we can say that it is the shape looking like a geoid also, like a ball and all. So what is there on the globe? What we can learn by seeing of the globe? It shows that about the seven continents. What are the seven continents are there? Asia, Europe, North America, South America, Australia, Antarctica. These all the continents we can see on the globe. And also the blue color it is there. Oceans also are there on the globe. Along with the ocean and continents, some countries also are there on the globe. It is the true model of the earth. Let us learn more information about the globe. So the globe, it is a, I told for you what is the meaning of the globe. Globe, a true model of the earth. It contains continents, oceans and countries. How we can be indicate and identify the countries and the oceans and continents also? We can identify the continents and oceans by the latitudes. We can divide the continents, or we can divide the oceans and all. The in between the latitudes and the longitudes also we can be writing. So here the earth is divided into the two halves. That is the equator. Now, for example, you take this one is the earth. The equator is divided into two. What do you mean by the equator? Equator, it is an imaginary line dividing earth in two equal halves. That is the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Importance of the equator also. This is the crossing through the middle, equator. It is the equator. When the equator is dividing the earth into two halves, it is the half part of the half. It is called the hemisphere. Half part is called the hemisphere. So it is the line equator is dividing. This is the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. The two, when the equator is dividing earth into two halves, the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, the two hemispheres are there. It is the imaginary lines only. The hemi means half part of the globe. So next term, in the same way, the axis. What do you mean by the axis? Axis is the imaginary line through the center of the earth joining two poles. What is the center of the earth imaginary line? This is the center of the earth. From this one, where the point, end point of the this middle of the line here indicates north pole and south pole. How we can show this one? The first one, we should know the directions. Now there are the four directions are there: north direction, south direction and west, east. So north to south to west to east. The earth is rotating from west to east. The round shape, the spin. The axis means the imaginary line to the center point, which is indicating the north pole and
south pole it is there. So let us read once again how to read about the globe, equator and axis. Let us learn tomorrow what are the importance of the latitudes. You have to read what is the meaning of the globe, the true model of the earth. What next? Equator, it is dividing the earth into two halves, and the northern hemisphere and two hemispheres are there. So once again, the center point of the earth, it is dividing north now. Tip of the point, it is called the north pole and south pole. Through the directions, we can learn the how to indicate north pole and south pole also.